Yeah, I'm trying to think other game. Well, there's I was like
Bulletstorm
because we were for ENN we were of course covering all the E3 stuff.
Yeah,
and man, the entire lineup for Nintendo. Like, I don't own a Wii, but I was like, maybe gonna have to get a Wii because I'm a big fan of like old school platformers, and like the Kirby one looks awesome.
Kirby's Epic Yarn is a lot of fun.
The Zelda. What's it called? The
Zelda
one looked really sweet too.
Wind, storm, something. I don't know.
So, yeah. That whole like when Nintendo was basically like, yeah, let's just do a new version of every single game we've ever made.
Yeah.
I was like, I will buy those games.
Are there any plans on some kind of schedule for the Let's Plays? Currently, no. But hopefully there will be, because hopefully we'll do more. And if they could become a semi-regular thing, that'd be a lot of fun for us and hopefully for you.
Yeah, so if you, if you like this, say so, either let the Escapist know in the forums or in this thread or whatever. And also, if you liked, in terms of the time, right, we were trying to do this at a time where the most people were available. But if Monday isn't a good day for you, or if you think that it would be better on some other day,
mm-hmm.
We were just doing it on Monday because that's when the other Unskippables come out, so it seemed like a logical way to do it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But there's no particular reason why it has to be on Monday. So, we'll be looking for feedback on that. And if we do another one, which I hope we do,
mm-hmm.
We'll see if we can do it at the best time for the most number of people. Obviously, it won't be for everybody, but...
You know. Yeah. What gave you the idea of Unskippable? We've talked about this before. We're both big fans of video games and big fans of Mr. Chan's Theater. And
seems like a no-brainer.
Yeah, years ago I was like, there's got to be more crossover than just us. Like, there's got to be people that like more people that like both, and I figured it was a, there's got to be.
Well, it's riffing on stuff is something we have wanted to do. Like, we did a little thing with Loading Ready Run called RR3K, which is sort of our Mystery Science Theater. We did it with like the shadows and everything, which was
a pain,
unnecessary. Yeah. And we were doing like old Predator Archive stuff, and it didn't work out that well. Like, it was okay, but maybe not so good. And so the Unskippable was sort of the latest variation on that, and obviously the most successful.
Mm-hmm. What's your favorite running gag from Unskippable? It's either number of times I've died, mm-hmm. or Russell.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of Mike Patton.
Mike Patton is the darkness. The moon is good too. We just mentioned that one last week.
Yeah.
The moon being huge in Japan.
The time I died, I don't know even what we are at right now, but that's pretty funny.
While the hate on Eternal Sonata after so long still making fun of Tenuto. Now, referencing...
That's a reference.
Referencing the joke is not still making fun of the game, which we, visit scenic Tenuto is just referencing one of our jokes. Why the hate on Eternal Sonata? Because... It takes forever.
I
love that game. Like, I love the battle system in that game was awesome, and it looks beautiful. But there's just so much dicking around.
Well, it's to me, like, Eternal Sonata, I think, epitomizes the...
I'm not texting, I'm reading the questions.
Eternal Sonata epitomizes the Unskippable game, right?
Yeah.
It's a very good game. That's incredibly beautiful, has a really cool battle system, lots of fun, but it's just dragged down by these terrible, long, long cutscenes. I believe the final cutscene is like an hour
long. It's like 45 minutes long.
Yeah, and there's like a save point in the middle of it. It's like, that's, you're doing it wrong.
Yeah.
So, that's like the most... perfect example of a Unskippable
game. And it also bothers me that you find out right at the beginning of the game that it's all a dream.
Mm. So it's like, what's the point of this?
You are playing as characters in a fever dream of Chopin before he dies.
Yes. And it's not like he's
And he's in it.
And but like if you, and it's not like if you win, he's not gonna die.
Yeah, exactly. You guys thinking of doing a you guys thinking of doing a co-op Let's Play?
That could be fun.
Something like Resident Evil 5. We can
I don't know. It might be tricky though, because it might require a little bit too much brain power. To be like, yeah, game, show up. Where's my healing herb?
Yeah.
Go. Nice thing about this one, especially good because there was no talking in this one, so we could basically just talk constantly.
Do you have any other games in mind for another Let's Play? No, but we'll start thinking about it right away.
Something like Secret of Mana, where it's like a JRPG, but you can pull in the second person.
That could be cool, yeah.
Probably not Secret of Mana, it's like super old.
So do you do Unskippable in that room? No, this is actually where I'm living right now. We do Unskippable at our moon base.
Orbiting underground moon base.
Yes.
But we're here because Graham's computer is super buff and powerful. So that allows us to operate, record the stream, send the stream out, and then do all the mixing with the microphones, doing the overlay. We're all doing this on one computer, which is normally somewhat taxing. So
I'm going to take a picture of it and post it to my Twitter. So, all right. Looks like we're sort of winding down on the questions.
All right.
There's a photo. Oh, you screenshotted as well? Fantastic. So, thank you all so much for watching.
If you screenshotted it, then it happened.
Exactly.
It's good.
Screenshots are proof. We would like to do another collaboration with Yahtzee. We just haven't talked about it yet. But I'm sure he'd be up for it. He's a cool dude. So thank you all for watching, and the 1,700 people who are still watching. I think we got pretty close to 2,000 viewers at one point.
Nice. Kissed 2,000.
Just kissed 2,000 and brushed it gently.
So you guys, anybody who saw the show and enjoyed it, tell all your friends so that next time we can have more than 2,000.
Yeah.
Like 5,000. Or how about 2,001?
Let's do that. All right. Space Odyssey for next time. Okay. Oh, 2014 apparently. Cool.
2014. Hey, there you go.
Sweet.
All right, 2015. Let's go for it next time.
Okay. Thanks, everyone, and we will see you next time.
And we will be seeing you continually every week on the other shows that we do.
Yeah, go watch today's Unskippable, and there'll be another one next week, and we'll be back. Thank you. Bye.